What's up, guys? Dos Santos Wife here. A lot of players are asking about my build in the comments, and today I want to share with you my favorite solo PvP build. This Bow Abaddon build is insane. I had a lot of fun playing this build, and it is incredible how good and effective it is for small PvP and solo PvE. I love to walk around solo or with some friends looking for an open PvP. With this build, I can do solo dungeons and Avalon chests. If you are new in the game and still don't know what build you want to play, this build will be perfect for you to start because it's not expensive and is very strong and effective for many kinds of content. The build starts with a Bow Abaddon, Mercenary Jacket, Mage Cowl, and any kind of leather shoes. I like Thetford Cape for PvE, but for PvP, I prefer Undead Cape. You can use Poison Potions for PvE, but also Healing and Omelets for PvP. All your passive skills from Jacket and Shoes need to be on Quick Thinker. This is very important because it will make all your skills cool down faster. Remember to have your passive skill from your bow to recover mana with normal hits. This is essential because you don't want to run away with mana during a fight. For PvE, the Storm from your Bow Abaddon and your Poison from the Mage Cowl will melt the mobs and bosses in any tier dungeon in Avalon Roads. You will combine with your Deadly Shot and Ray of Light. Dude, this is incredible amount of area damage. You will able to easily clear any tier of solo dungeons and kill Avalon mobs. If you need to be healed, you can use your Poison and Storm to heal yourselves at almost full HP combined with your Mercenary Jacket. Remember to have the passive skills on your Quick Thinker and use Omelets and Healing Potions. This will in turn make you have your cooldown back work faster and your life sustain during the fights because your Jacket and your Healing Potions. It will also enable you to fight two or more enemies solo if you play it right. When I fight melee players, it is an almost guaranteed win because I use Frost Shot, Poison Arrows from Q, the Storm from Bow, and the Poison from Mage Cowl. I am able to then do a large amount of damage without even letting my enemies touch me while keeping my distance and making them eat all my poison skills. When I fight range enemies, I like to use Ray of Light because there's no point in using Frost Shot. The Ray of Light increases a crazy amount of damage in my game, and I'm able to keep the enemies under the storm for longer rooting them. I am 700 in bow spec, and when I'm using a 6.2 or 5.3 Baden, the total amount of combination damage is 3.984 total. This includes 2 deadly shots, 1 Ray of Light, and all the hits from the storm. Total of 23 hits during a 4.8 seconds, which is not hard to do. I keep players under the full storm on the time with Ray of Light. I sometimes stay under my own storm during the fight when the enemy are very close to me. Another thing to remember is that the storm cancels any kind of casting skills. This is very good to kill holy healers because they need to cast their own skills to heal themselves. This build is also good to dismount players on their mounts. I can chase them in open worlds, causing a lot of damage with your poisons and storm, and even bloodletters and double blades can't run away from me. Well guys, this was my favorite solo opening world, PvP and PvE build that I wanted to share with you. I hope you liked the video, and if you're a beginner and looking for a build to start, then this is the one for you. Don't forget to subscribe, leave your like, and let me know in the comments what is your favorite solo build. Thanks, and see you again in the Abinio world.